everybody. Welcome to Faith on Friday Extra. This series is all about highlighting people, topics, and businesses that I know you will find interesting, inspiring, and always educational. And I'm your host, Rikki Smith. All right, y'all. Y'all are in for a treat today. So you've heard the saying that age ain't nothing but a number, and we won't finish the rest of that for you R. Kelly fans. But let me tell you something. Aging is different than getting old. And I want to introduce you to my friend whom I call my mom. Her name is Lula Page Drewery. Hi, Miss Lula.
Hi, Miss Rikki.
We are talking about aging and aging well today. And this woman is doing it like nobody's business. To look at this gorgeous woman, I know y'all don't know how old she is, but I do. And she said it's okay to tell y'all. Miss Lula is actually she will be 73 years old this year. Isn't that right, Miss Lula?
73 in July.
All right, now, and doing the most. You are looking so beautiful.
And feeling well.
That is what we want to talk about. So, Miss Lula, now, I know, and just like you, everybody grows older. But not everybody ages well. What do you think is the difference?
I think the difference is embracing the state that you're in.
Oh, that's good.
We have to remember that if we're going to live, we're going to get older. So you have to embrace that. And that's what I do. I embrace every day that the Lord gives me.
I know.
And I think that's what makes me happy. And I think that's what all people that's aging should do. Mm-hmm. You have to embrace it. You can't get up every day and say, oh, woe is me. I'm 73. What's going to happen? Mm-hmm. We know what's going to happen. We're going to get older if we still live.
That's right.
Embrace the journey.
Embrace the journey. That is so good. Now, have you always had that attitude? Because I know I remember being 10 years old and thinking that if I'm ever 30, oh, just kill me now because 30 is so old, you know? And so now I'm well over 30, glory to God, and I don't feel the same way. So have you felt this way always about getting older and aging, that it was just going to be okay?
Well, when I was younger, of course, you think that you're gonna be gorgeous forever. But we all know that things change, mm-hmm. and a part of changing is growing. And I think on my journey, I think I've learned to love myself more at this age than
good.
I ever have. Mm-hmm. And that doesn't come when you're young. Mm. So the journey to aging can be a wonderful thing if you embrace it, like I said.
Yeah. So what do you do every day? I mean, are you getting up or lifting weights, drinking raw eggs? What are you doing to stay so beautiful? Because you kind of are sexy. I'm just letting you know.
Well, one thing that I do is I drink lots of water. I have my water. And I do exercise. I walk at least 2 miles a day with my husband. Mm-hmm. And if I don't walk, I have a machine in the back. I walk on the machine and I try to do things. I read a lot. I've gotten to the point where I read quite a bit, thanks to my children having books out. Thank you, Rikki. and I read quite a bit. And during the day, I sometimes watch TV. Sometimes I don't. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I play games on my phone. Sometimes I don't. Mm-hmm. It's just according to how I feel that day.
Yeah. Yeah. And so it is about moving. Keep moving.
You have to move.
Yeah.
If you don't move, you will be sorry.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I'm glad that I embraced taking care of myself at a young age.
Yeah.
I was not a drinker. I was never a smoker.
Mm-hmm.
And thank God that that didn't play a role in my health.
Right.
So, you young girls, get plenty of sleep, moisturize, and pray.
Would say moisturize and pray.
Moisturize and pray.
I love it. I love it. So growing up, now you were talking about the health issues. Now I'm sure you have come through with perfect health, no drama. So you're going to live to your 100, right?
No, not exactly. I was diagnosed with a heart problem when I was in my late 20s.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I'm on my fourth pacemaker. People would never know.
Nope.
But I was diagnosed with a heart problem to the point where my heart would stop.
Mm-hmm.
And I had to end up having a pacemaker.
Sure.
But from that experience, I came into it in my late 20s.
Mm-hmm.
So I was always a runner during those times. The only thing I wasn't doing was getting enough sleep because I was in the clubs.
Well,
that's
weren't we all at one time? Be really real. I know that.
But other than the club, there
yeah.
was no alcohol, no drugs involved.
Mm, right.
So just staying up too late.
Yeah.
But girls, don't stay in the club. Get your rest.
Get some sleep. Yes. Okay. So then, Ms. Lula, as you're doing things, how important, as you're aging, how important are relationships in your life?
Very, very important. Mm-hmm. As you know, Rikki, both of my children are adults and they're grown. They don't live here. They live in Dallas. Mm-hmm. And thank God for the church that I've made so many. I've gotten so many adult children who call me mom or mother or whatever. And that's been a blessing to my life. Mm-hmm. If it wasn't for some of those relationships, my husband and I, we would be really sad. Mm-hmm. But those, you girls keep me young and happy and thinking about whatever you're going to say to me next.
Yeah. Well, see, for you all that don't know, Ms. Lula Drewery, she's talking like this, but I'm going to tell you, and you'll see some pictures of her. The woman is kind of a fashionista. Her hats and pearls and dresses, oh my, she has the closet that I want when I get 70, anything. She still wears her heels and she still hangs out with her man. How long you been married, Miss Lula?
37 years.
Amen. That's so wonderful.
And he's such a blessing.
Yes. And we're not going to get you started because we know your mind goes so
you
far.
Know, you know that song, Never Would Have Made It? Mm. I wouldn't have made it without God and this man.
Mm. That's nice. So to have a loving relationship at this age is still important.
It's very important because you tend to feel that you're not needed anymore at a certain age.
Wow.
You've raised your children. In our case, our grandchildren are grown. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's easy to sit back and say, well, what's the use? What's the need?
Yeah.
But God has planted so many children and grandchildren. Your son is my grandson. And even I got a great grand in your through you. So,
Yeah. You
know, I don't have a great grand through my biological children yet. Mm-hmm. And I don't know if I'll get there, but I got them through other people.
Yeah.
I got them through you.
Yeah. And you are one busy lady because you do a lot of volunteering as well.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. At first, when I retired from GECU Credit Union, mm-hmm. I needed to do something else. So I began to work at El Paso Independent School District,
right.
Which was such a blessing. I worked with children who were basically autistic. Mm-hmm. Children had disabilities. Mm-hmm. And at one point, I was in the classroom. I was a paraprofessional. Okay. And from that, I ended up being a bus monitor aide for special need children.
Yeah.
And let me tell you, those 7 years that I spent with those children showed me so much that they don't have any quit in them. It's get up and go every day, even
right.
with your disabilities.
Mm-hmm.
So they
were
a real blessing to me. Oh, yes. Mm-hmm. Every day I learn something different.
Mm-hmm.
And I thank God that I'm learning every day.
Right.
Every day I read something and I go, I didn't know that.
Yeah, me too. Look, y'all, I know that we could talk to Miss Lula forever. I actually do. So just so you know, be jealous. But don't worry, you will be able to, we have her information in the description. You'll be able to find her on Facebook and, you know, Messenger. But while you're here, don't forget, subscribe to our YouTube channel, give us a thumbs up and leave us a comment because we're all getting older, but are you aging well? Miss Lula, before we let you go, my friend, we got to play our game.
Okay.
All right. So this game is called This or That. It's pretty simple. I'm going to give you the choice of two different things, and you just tell me which one you like the best. Are you ready to play?
I'm ready.
All right. Let's do this. Android or iPhone?
iPhone.
Read the book or see the movie?
See the movie.
Wallflower or life of the party?
According to what day it is, life of the party.
I know. Summertime fun or winter wonderland?
Summertime fun.
Eat to live or live to eat?
Live to eat.
Mm-hmm. And she's a good cook, y'all, just saying. Out in nature or stuck in the house?
Out in nature.
Mm. Coke or Pepsi?
Neither.
Can't
have caffeine.
Well, it's probably better for you anyway. Drive
mm-hmm.
the car or ride?
Ride.
Mm. I like sports or I don't care?
Love sports.
Yes, you do. Who's your football team, Mom?
My football team right now, I change, but the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Okay. Yeah, that's true. Okay.
Yeah.
Mom, when you were younger, what was your first job?
My first job was at McDonald's.
I could see you there.
Yes.
Skinning and grinning.
It was in Hawaii. Okay. And the girls there wore a smock top and they had the little Hawaiian bow. And I was the only African American in the whole place. And I just had such a great time. I was going to night school at night and mm-hmm. working at McDonald's during the day while my boys were in school. That's so it was awesome. So much fun.
I bet. You all, thank you so much for watching. Mom, thanks so much for joining me. I appreciate it.
I thank you so much for having me.
All right, everybody. That's it for this time, but we'll see you next time on Extra.